What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Hey, Play That One Game. I'm actually re-recording the first episode because the first episode I did last night, I had some video problems and I don't think it's going to come out. So just as a precaution, I'm re-recording this first episode. I don't mind playing through the first part. It's starting to like this game quite a bit. So if you can't tell by the title, we are playing Enslaved Odyssey to the West, developed by Ninja Theory. Alright, let's get started. Pressing start. New journey. Normal. Yep. Yeah, the first episode that I did, I didn't set my video settings right on the PS3. And it looks squashed, and I'm afraid that when I upload it to YouTube, it's gonna have all those white watermarks and video artifacts and all that, and I don't want that.
Welcome to Slave Ship 909, en route to Pyramid. You have been assessed, and any injuries sustained during your capture have been designated as non-life-threatening. Remaining journey time is estimated at 16 hours.
So we got that Goku-looking dude. Or a Super Saiyan looking dude.
Position beneath your feet.
He's pretty pissed.
A new life awaits you.
What does it?
Free from the random hazards of the wild. Compliance will be rewarded with safety and sustenance. Non-compliance will be rewarded with pain. Warning. Temperature critical. Structural integrity 30%.
Bust out of the egg. Super mutant. What's up, man? Yeah, it's, I'm talking a little low. People are asleep. It's pretty early on a Sunday morning. He's offline. Sorry, man. Go back to sleep.
Alert! Prisoner loose in carriage 9! Prisoner loose in
carriage 9! Affirmative. Blade 949. Combat mechs activating.
Hey. Oh, that's cool. Ragdoll physics. Sorry. I guess I go back. God. Yeah.
Hey,
question is, how did she get over there?
Alert. Hull breach. Alert. Hull breach.
Think so? Yeah, in the original video, the original take that I did of this, everything looked pretty washed out. And it was my own dumbass, I didn't set some of the audio sounds correctly, as I mentioned before.
Where are you going?
Yeah, where are you going?
Let's get off this thing!
So now I gotta jump down. So this was made with the Unreal Engine.
Integrated slaves report to escape pods.
No, any of you who are watching this are game developers, which messed with UDK or Unreal Development Kit. It's pretty nice, a little complicated. But if you want your stuff to look nice, follow the engines you can use. Yeah, I'm looking forward to using the Cry Engine. Actually, I'll go this way. That one also is also a nice looking engine. I'm glad that it's cheaper with no royalties. That robot just like killed everybody.
I can't find this thing.
No, you can't. You need your weapons.
Gotta get my weapons back.
Okay.
Where's my stuff? The stuff. Where's my gear? The stuff you took away from me.
I can't talk to you. It's against the rules. Item storage in the lower hall.
Drink a Slurpee. No. Brain freeze. Alright.
Escape pod 8 launched. 7 pods remaining.
7 pods remaining.
My ride. At least I can get my gear back.
That is Darth Maul's lightsaber.
Okay. Let's deal with that neck. Here we go.
Yeah, it's one of those situations where you don't want to say what you're thinking, because then it'll actually happen. Like, right now.
Activating combat mech.
Yeah.
Come on!
combat in this game is actually pretty fluid. Is this where I went? No, the other way. Okay. Nope. Thank you.
Oh no! You gotta be kidding me!
No, turn around. Oh, okay, so... Yeah. I made a comment about what happens later on at the end of the very first episode, or the first recording of this episode. Now that I look at this, it kind of makes sense. Now I'm replaying it. I'll mention it when it happens. Cool, I do fell off.
Yo.
I just wish the movement controls were a little bit more fluid. Going through these platform segments is pretty good. Another thing that's kind of. In a way, it's good and bad. It's good because it makes traversing through this level a little bit easier, but then it's also bad because it's a challenge. If anybody knows what I mean, because it's like a combination of both. Where, yeah, it's a little easier to traverse, but then you also have to have some kind of more precision. Not just like automatically jump to the spot. But I guess nowadays everything's easier. Not like back in the day where you had to actually work to get to where you had to go.
Bro.
is actually pretty cool that you have to get up before the building. It's actually really cool. It adds a little bit more tension. Look at this way. Actually, I really like that. But I wonder. I guess next time I play through this, I'll check to see if what happens if we don't make it. Probably you die, but. Longer than 10 seconds, by the way. Just can't do it. Ouch. That looked like it hurt. Bambi. So I'm interested in to find out what actually happened, why everything's in ruin and all that. There's a pod. There's monkey guy. Goku. That's what I call him. Goku.
It's ripped open.
It's the headband.
What?
The slave headband. The one I fit on you.
You put this on me.
Let me explain.
Get this thing off, or I'm gonna rip your head off.
No.
No?
No.
You think I'm screwing with you?
He also he also drank Slurpees too fast.
It works. Command, move away from me.
What the hell are you doing?
I hacked a slave headband so it could be activated by my voice commands.
So like I mentioned in the activation triggers a systemic pain. I'll wait till after this cutscene.
It's what controls the slaves. You can't. My heart stops beating for any reason. The headband will discharge a lethal dose. If I die, you die.
Oh.
come from a wind farm community. It's about 300 miles from here. I'll never make it on my own. If slavers don't get me, Max will. That's the deal. Get me back to my home and you can go back to yours.
Looks like I don't have a choice.
Neither of us do. I'm sorry.
You're not sorry. Shut up.
Okay. Let's go.
Command, stay with me.
All right, so like I was saying earlier, just a little fun fact about this game.
What the hell is all this stuff?
I actually bought this game and also Vanquish when I was on a business trip to the United Arab Emirates. I was in Dubai and I saw this game for about $11 or $12 new, along with Vanquish. So I got both of them. They have a PAL region, but I mean, the majority of PS3 games are pretty much region-free, so which is actually pretty nice, because there's a lot of titles that I would like to play that are not, that weren't released in America. And at the time, it was really hard to find this game and Vanquish new for a decent price, so I jumped at the opportunity to get it.
This must have been some kind of gathering point.
Yep, Dubai and Abu Dhabi are pretty
Is this the way out?
Good cities to visit. It's a pretty good vacation spot if you got the money. I remember there are some glowy balls around here. Shut up. Got some glowy balls. Huh. I guess it saved the amount that I had in my original game. I wonder what those do. Should read the manual. Light generator. Email.
I think this must be a drawbridge.
Must be to keep Max out.
There are some controls here. The other side is blocked. Can you get around and clear it?
No. But I guess I'm gonna have to. There's the pipe.
Be careful!
Shut up. I know what I'm doing. I did this before, man.
What was that?
Max, keep your voice down. It could be close.
What are we gonna do?
Not make too much noise.
Oh. It's the kukui. The Kukui is kind of like the boogeyman. That's what Hispanics and Mexicans used to tell their kids just to get them to do things, you know? They used to tell me, like, if I wanted to go to like a certain area of the house when I was younger, they would tell me, don't go in there because the Kukui is going to get you. So, of course, me being like 2 or 3 years old, I would believe them, and I would get scared, and go. Come on. Hopefully she doesn't get stuck like last time.
could get out through here.
Yes, we can.
Can you move this?
Can lift that. This dude is strong, man. I wish I could get strong like him, work out and stuff. By the way, there are some stuff. There is a. It's all right.
Do you think you could tell me what the plan is?
Just. Wow. Like I mentioned in the first video, or the first time I tried to record this, I really like the way they use color. Here.
To get
it's
you
not like the typical
possible,
games that are coming out right now that are brown and gray and kind of like. Everything looks the same and.
I meant.
But this is actually really nice.
See that smoke over there?
I think I'll play Crysis 3 after this, because I'm anxious to see what they do with New York and all that.
Survived the crash.
I heard that it's actually pretty.
Right.
It looks gorgeous.
The only way I know how to cover 300
we might.
Two wheels and an engine.
Alright. So.
There must have been thousands
as I mentioned before, the first time I recorded this, and I came back here. And there is a glowy ball right there.
I wonder what happened to them all.
And also, there was one in one of these cars. And over here somewhere.
Hurry up.
Shut up. It started annoying me. And also in these shipping containers, there's also glowy balls and stuff. Don't want to jump up there, son of a bitch. Yeah, avoid taking bullets. That's good advice. It's like someone shot at me. Let me see if I can stop the bullet with my face. Glowy balls. Yeah. I like how fluid the combat is. It's actually really nice. I think I mentioned that earlier. Come on. Let's do this. Glowy balls.
If we are gonna get through this, then when I ask you to do something, you need to do it immediately.
Okay. I understand.
No, you don't. I need to look for the health. Health is, I believe, back here it is, yeah. Alright. Like I mentioned before, there are all these glowy balls all over the shipping containers and then that concrete pipe right there. And also around this light post. And over here, I believe. I think that's it. So, hold L1. Press up and let's go.
Okay.
And also, the first time I played this, the girl actually got stuck somewhere and I had to restart this whole area again, which was kind of annoying. Go. Games aren't perfect. Nothing's perfect, not even software. You know.
My father gave it to me. It knocks out small mechs for a few seconds.
Good old dad.
Enough to give me a chance to get away. The security door is still functioning. There must be live power cells around here.
Doesn't matter. You shouldn't get sidetracked. We just need to get to the crash site.
I need a new chair. Mine's noisy as fuck. So this is where we're going to stop for episode 1. So thanks for watching. Any comments, questions, concerns, or whatever, I welcome anything. I'm going to strive to make this series a lot better. So yeah, just give me some comments, suggestions, and see what I could do better. Alright, thanks for watching, guys.